living in the atmosphere. I said, ooh, it's hot in here. There's too much carbon in the atmosphere.
Nadat die omgewingsgroep Sierra Club donderdag in Durban begrafnis gehou het vir steenkool as energiebron, het hulle vrydagoggend ook hulle koppe in die sand begrawe om te spot met lande wat volgens hulle nie genoeg doen teen klimaatsverandering nie.
Well, every country is different with respect to what they can do, and the UN Climate Conference Climate Agreement recognizes differentiated responsibilities. Obviously, South Africa relies tremendously on coal, and at the same time, you have tremendous solar resources and wind resources right off the coast. It's really important that every country do their part. A country like South Africa can actually serve its rural populations and its poorest people better with distributed energy like solar than it can by building massive coal and nuclear power plants to ship the electricity all over the countryside. You can actually raise people's standard of living and provide them with electricity much cheaper by installing solar in rural villages, for example. And many instances, those people are the ones who are passed by in these massive development schemes. So that's what we think. And let me just say this, it's not for me as an American to tell South Africa what to do, but I talk with a lot of South African activists while I'm here, and they're concerned about the amount of coal that your country relies on. And we've been talking with them about what we've been doing in the United States to start to phase us out of coal. I mean, it's incredibly important. We have a lot of people working in the fossil fuel industry. We want to make sure that we actually create new jobs for people in renewable energy. So it's not about turning out the lights. It's about looking to renewable clean energy so that we can actually maintain a good standard of living, extend that privilege to the poorest people, and at the same time address the critical issue of climate change.